Welcome to Excel Tips and Tricks. My name is Andreas de Jong. In today's video, I want to show you how to add a second horizontal axis to an Excel chart. This is an important skill to have if you want to plot operational curves or reservoirs. In this chart, you can see how the reservoir storage capacity in MCM is related to the elevation of the water level. The data is plotted on the primary axis. We also want to add the reservoir surface area in hectares on the secondary axis and show the values in reverse order. Okay, let's get started. We'll be using data from the Kajaki reservoir in Afghanistan. The data comes from a survey carried out by the USGS in 1968. Okay, here we are in Excel. Let's have a look at our data. Select everything, double-click between the columns, and it opens up for us. We'll format this first of all as a table. Select it all, go to Home, Format as Table, and we'll select my favorite one, the blue one. It has headers, yes. However, going in Table Design, let's unclick the filter button because I don't want to change the sequence of this data. I think I'll do a bit of formatting on this table. Right-click, Format Cells, Alignment, choose Center, and Wrap Text. Okay, another thing we could do is just to change these number formats. Right-click, Format Cells, Number, select Number, use the 1000 separators and one decimal place. So now what we actually want to do is make a chart of our data. So let's select our elevation, storage capacity and surface area, select the titles and the data, go to Insert, Charts, and we want the scatter chart with smooth lines. I'm going to open it up a little bit. All right, what you'll notice immediately is that on the x-axis here we have our elevation, which should actually be on our y-axis. So there's two ways we can swap them around. I'll show you both of them. First of all, let's try method one. Go to Chart Design, select data, and we'll work on the storage capacity first of all. Go to Edit, and you can see the data is in columns C and D, so let's select column C and change it to D. Press Enter and change this one to C and say OK. So now you can see that it has changed the X and Y axis. Okay, for the surface area, we want to do something similar. Just select the y-axis, put it here, swap them around and like this. So basically, what I've done is I've just moved them manually for the area and used the standard approach for the other one. All right, so just click on them to make sure that it's looking good. Now our surface area should be on the secondary axis. So let's right click, Format Data Series, select secondary axis. Nothing much has changed. We actually want to have it going the other way. So what we do now is go to Chart and Add Chart Element. Under Axis, you'll see there is a secondary horizontal axis shown here. Just click on it and now you can see that this is the secondary axis, which is now at the top. We also want to reverse the order of it. So right click, Format Axis, Values in Reverse Order. And be careful because you can see that the vertical axis is now two of them. So we want to select Automatic here for where it crosses the vertical axis. Okay, not bad. So let's change some of the formatting of our axis. Format the axis and go to Number, and I don't think we need any decimal places, but here we do want a 1000 separator, so no decimal places, category, Number, also no decimal places. Okay, the next thing we need to do is to add a couple of titles. Go to Chart Design, Add Chart Element, Axis Titles, and Instead of picking them all individually, we'll just click on this bottom option, More Axis Title Options, click, and you can see that we now have axis titles on all of our axes. I'm going to just quickly fill these in. Okay, so we have our elevation on the y-axis, our storage capacity on the primary x-axis, and our area on the secondary x-axis, going in reverse order. We should also add a chart title. It's not bad, but I'd like these grid lines to line up a bit. So this goes from 0 to 2000. Maybe if we make this from 0 to 10,000. Okay, so now the grid lines line up. I think it's time to make a copy of it and move it, move the chart so that we can have a better look at the final output. I don't like the borders, so no border. But this is a bit difficult to read, so I'm going to change all this to font 12. Okay, not bad. Let's make the lines a bit thicker. And also want to change the markers, so increase the size to 8, and I want them filled with white so that you can distinguish them from the lines. It's always a good idea to use different marker types in case somebody wants to photocopy this just in black and white. If you like, you can even change the lines. So now it's really clear which one is the storage capacity and which is the surface area. Okay, so this is our final output for today. I hope you found this video useful and look forward to seeing you on the next one, where we'll look into the storage area curves in more detail.